I'm Don Hatfield, and I am the product manager for wireless BMS products at Intrepid Control Systems. What we have here is the ADI version of a chipset for communicating with wireless battery pack nodes. In essence, what we're showing here is pretty much what every customer initially wants and usually uses in their systems, in their test systems, in DV testing, PV testing, end-of-line tests, etc. Essentially, what everyone would like would be to get the data from the battery pack from each of the nodes, and then to take that data in from a manager, but then spit it out on CAN into other test systems, test benches, etc. What we have here is the battery simulator. So you'll actually see a row of small connectors that are essentially the battery simulation themselves. And I have a way to adjust that with a potentiometer. And also the node simulator. Both of these are actually from analog devices in this particular case. But this could be your own node and your own circuit board. So on the RAD-wBMS, we have two antennas. These antennas are used to connect up to the node. Or you have this iGrid connector, which is used for wired connections to WBMS manager or to other associated ECUs. For the RAD-wBMS manager, we have two different options to connect to the device, to put it to your test system or to a PC. The first way is USB. So we have a USB connector here. You can also connect to it with Ethernet. So power options, there's actually two different power options as well. With USB, it runs without any additional power from any other connector. If you use Ethernet, there is no PoE, but we do have a micro DB9 connector that has the ability to use to provide power to the WBMS. And then finally, CAN also comes out that same connector, and we provide an adapter that gets it to a standard DB9. And then the WBMS is taking that data and transferring it to CAN, which is actually being read over the value CAN. So essentially, in a battery pack, you start out with a cell. Those cells are assembled into small, it almost looks like a very small battery pack, but I would call it a node. And then those several nodes are placed inside of a battery pack, and then it's sealed up and put into the vehicle. If you're using a wired BMS, this means you have to wire up each and every one of those nodes. So that uses copper, which is time in manufacturing, its weight and range and cost, because you're using more copper than you probably need to. And so in an ideal world, what would you like to do? You would love to have a wireless connection between each of the nodes so that there is no copper and there is no hand assembly or having to do any kind of wiring in between each of the nodes and the manager. A device that essentially is the brains of that node, and that's connected to the batteries, which in this case, we have a battery simulator, and then we have a node simulator, okay? And these are actually development boards that come from ADI in this particular case. You can have many of these, 12 or 16 of those inside of a single battery pack, and you can operate multiple managers at the same time with a single silicon chip. And what you see on the screen is actually what we call VRLA. Intrepid's VRLA software is essentially a tool where you can make your own graphical interfaces, put in code, and create your own tests if you'd like, as well as see the actual data coming out. So the data comes out of the battery packs, out of the nodes, if you will, and then that gets transmitted wirelessly to the WBMS. Now, normally in a manufactured vehicle, each of these is inside of a single sealed case, okay? So all the wireless takes place within the case itself. But when you are in a bench situation and you need to talk to a node or to create a test, then you would have to have your own wireless manager that you can use. And so there's several different choices. One would be you essentially use the ECU that you're developing at the same time, you're using it to be essentially a testing device to gather your data. Another way would be to get the analog devices boards. You could get the development boards to do the manager as well. But the problem with those is that, number one, your ECU is under development, so every time the code changes, you've got to change your test setup. And those ECUs are very difficult to get often at the beginning. With the development boards, those are not made to be produced in large volume. They're only for evaluations. So the option that ADI and Intrepid have worked together to make is the RAD-wBMS, which has its own APIs. It can be used as its own test tool to connect up to a node or to a set of nodes, just like the manager that's actually in the battery pack. As another option, on one end here, right between the antennas, there's actually a connector. That connector is made to connect via isoSPI to the manager itself or to other devices that are on isoSPI connected to the battery manager. So that way, I can actually use the actual battery management ECU, and I can connect up the actual nodes, but use the WBMS as a test tool to load in new configurations, as well as to do testing of the complete system using isoSPI and the other associated ECUs. So in this case, I said at the beginning, well, this is actually demonstrating the most common use case. And I talked a little bit about CAN, and I haven't said anything about CAN yet. So the WBMS has a special feature, which you can enable, that essentially automatically creates a CAN gateway. So in essence, when you load the nodes and manager, depending on your test situation, when you load them with the configuration from ADI software, it automatically will create a gateway to CAN, and it will give you a database file that you can use to then use in your test tools and create the rest of your test. And instead of writing your own script or even using the gateway builder, which is handy for making your own specialized gateway, this is nothing more than a single click in configuration and then getting the database file out of our software. Then you can use it in other test tools. And to top it all off, this runs independently in that case. I could have this set up to do nothing more than a gateway. It's not hooked up to a computer if I don't want it to be, but I can hook it up to a computer, and I can also do the gateway at the same time, which is very common for Intrepid products. We try to do everything you need into a single box versus having multiple boxes for multiple systems like simulation versus reading the bus. For this demo, we're actually showing a gateway from WBMS to CAN. And so what we're showing here is the battery pack simulators. You can have multiple ones. We just have one in this particular demo, just to save for room. And then that's connecting wirelessly to the WBMS. And then you'll see that from the WBMS, it's connected up to the computer. In this case, we're using USB. The CAN is actually coming out not just on USB in this particular case, it's actually coming out the value CAN 4 as a separate gateway, but this general graphic actually is not quite the same. You can do it this way where it's only going to the laptop. So as I change the potentiometer, you'll see that the numbers go up and down, and that's actually wirelessly being sent from the node to the WBMS, and we're picking it up through the wireless antennas. For more information, feel free to contact me. My name is Don Hatfield. I'm the wireless BMS manager for Intrepid.